Hello and welcome back students. As I already told you that this chapter is going to divide into three parts. So this is the second part from the chapter The Living and the Non-Living. So we covered up to topic that living beings grow and they also follow a life cycle and reproduce. In animals, they lay eggs or they give direct birth. Or in plants, there are so many ways, like they grow from the roots, the stem, the leaves. So up to here we completed. Now we have next feature that living beings need food. So on the basis of their food requirement, we divide into two parts. Heterotrophs in two groups. One is heterotrophs, second is autotrophs. Heterotrophs and autotrophs. What are heterotrophs? Hetero means other than self and trophs means feeder. So the living beings which depend upon others to get their food. So for example, humans depend upon plants. Insects are also depend upon another insects and plants. Animals like lion or carnivore animals depend upon the flesh of another animals. So they all are example of heterotrophs. And what are autotrophs? They make their own food. What are autotrophs which make their own food? Green plants are the autotrophs because they make their food by photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? By the process of making food in presence of sunlight, in which carbon dioxide they intake and oxygen release through stomata. But there is one main pigment use, that is chlorophyll. In photosynthesis, leaves use chlorophyll that help plants to make their food. And this is also the reason that why the leaves are of green color, because there is a presence of chlorophyll. Now there is an important part in the leaves, that is stomata. What is the function of stomata? Stomata help in photosynthesis. How it help? It help to take carbon dioxide inside and release oxygen out. So by this activity, stomata help in the photosynthesis process. Now where stomata is present? Stomata is present on the lower surface of the leaves mostly, but not some plants are there in which stomata is present on the upper surface. For example, lotus is an aquatic plant and it is fixed. So in that plant the stomata is present on the upper surface. Now the next feature of living being is that living being respires. What is respires? The exchange of gases inside the living being is respire. So the process of taking in air, letting oxygen combine with food and throwing out carbon dioxide and water vapor is called respiration. So what is respire? The exchange of gases. But what is respiration? The process of taking in air and letting oxygen combine with food. Why oxygen need to combine with food? To get the energy. We need energy to run our daily function of the body, to grow, to fight the disease. We need food. So food will combine with oxygen. And in this process, we will get carbon dioxide and water vapors, which will be throwing out in the process of respiration. We can also say the process of breathing in and breathing out is a part of respiration. The complete process of respiration is the when oxygen mix with food, and in that chemical reaction we will get carbon dioxide and water vapors as a product, and they will throw out from the body. That complete is a process of respiration. But what is the part from there? One part is that breathing in and breathing out. In humans, how we can observe that respiration is going on? We can see their chest is moving up and down in animals and in human also. But some animals live in water like fish. They breathe by their gills. And they take in water from there. The air which is dissolved or the oxygen which is dissolved in water, they separate it. And how plants breathe? Plants breathe through their stomata, which is present in the leaves. Now the next feature we have, that is living being excrete. What is excrete? The process of throwing out waste is called excretion. Now we are living beings, we need food, we will eat food to get energy. So the process of breaking down or digesting the combined food with oxygen is respiration. That produce waste, means which is not useful for us now. So we need to throw it out. So animals expel their body waste in the form of feces and urine. And sweating is also example of in which we expel the or we throw out the waste from the body. This is in animals. But in case of plants, plants also throw out their waste. So the next point we have, or next feature we have of living beings, that living being excrete. What is excrete means? The process of throwing out waste is called excretion. We need food to get energy, but after processing it or the process of respiration, we will also get the waste. So this waste, we not have any use of this. So animals or humans expel their waste from the body in the form of feces and urine. And sweating is also example in which we expel or we throw out our waste from the body. But in case of plant, what is the difference? They also throw out their waste because they are also living beings. So, and this is the feature of living beings, that living beings excrete. They throw out their waste. Now we discussed about the animals, but plants are also living beings, means they will also excrete. So in case of plants throw out their waste in the form of gases from their stomata, and they also store their waste in special cell. Some of these waste are useful for us. So the waste we get from the plants are very useful for us. For example, rubber we get from the latex, which is a waste of a plant, or we will say it a rubber tree. So the waste of the plants, we use them to make rubber, to make gums. So there are so many use. Now one more example I'm going to discuss, that is milkweed plant. In Hindi the name is aak, and it is present in our lands, like in Haryana. The milkweed plant you commonly found near the ponds or in any land which is present around your fields. So when you remove one leaf from the plant, the milky liquid will come out. That is the waste of the plant. Now the second last feature of living beings in your chapter is living beings respond to stimuli. Now what is stimuli? A stimulus is something which produces a response. Anything, like when you try to slap someone, they will react to it, they will blink their eyes. So this is the response. Another stimulus you can do, that you can hide behind the door and try to scare someone, shout very loudly, so they will respond to your action. So these are the stimulus. So how we will define that response to a external stimuli living beings do? So when you change temperature, when you switch off the light or you remove the light, turn on the light, water, pressure, sound, touch, chemical and some external stimuli, that living being respond. So in that case we will come to know that they are living beings. Suppose at your home there is a table present, you will throw water on it, यू विल डिक्रीज द टेम्परेचर और इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर. यू कैन पुट टेबल इन टू द रूम और इन टू आउटसाइड सनलाइट. दे विल नॉट द टेबल विल नॉट रिस्पॉन्ड बट द लिविंग बींग विल रिस्पॉन्ड टू दिस स्टिमुली. सो वाट इज स्टिमुली? दैट एनी stimulus something which produce a response or reaction in a living being. Now there are some example that there is a touch me not plant, or in Hindi we will the name is chui mui. When we touch the leaf of the plant they will close, means they will respond to the touch. Now in this figure the plant will respond to the sunlight. They cut a card box and make some boxes. By making one box they cut the slits from it, then they put a plant, then plant will move toward the sunlight, so it is responding to the sunlight. Now in this case there is a earthworm and the paper is dipped in the salt. When we dip it into the water near the earthworm, earthworm will start moving away from it, so it is responding to the salt water. Now the last point is living organism show movement. So why living organism need to move? Because they need food, they need shelter, or they need to escape from their enemies. These are the main points. They need to move. So you can see by your eyes also, dog, cats, horses walk and run, birds and some insects also fly, snake crawl. So these all are the features which characterize living beings. Like non-living things do not move and living things show movement. And I hope all this chapter is clear to you. So I will also share link of the first part in the description box. You can check from there. And in next video part 3 I will going to discuss the exercise questions. Thanks for watching, students. I hope you will learn something new from this video.